Coming up on High School Game Night, a Section 1 clash between two of the top offenses in the LL League, Warwick and Manheim Township.
And then a pair of excellent Section 2 offenses took the field in Denver, the Arizona Garden Spot versus the Ground Game of Calico. Those highlights and a lot more are coming up right now on High School Game Night.
Give me a break down.
1, 2, 3.
Mouse, be a better, better.
You can't beat me.
Ball, beat me.
Matt Folk is going to go the distance, touchdown.
Hello and welcome to High School Game Night, the post-game show. Other high school sports moving into the playoffs, Brian, but we are still into this football schedule. So happy to be back from my overseas tours. I'm Chad Landers.
Yep, I can't believe they let you back into the country,
Chad.
It was tough. It was hard.
I'm
Brian Cass. The theme for this week is offense. Lots of points being scored here in Week 7.
Week 7, yeah. Feature game of the night here on BRC 11. Garden Spot, Calico. Two opposing philosophies on offense. Garden Spot and Cameron Roth, they love to throw it. Calico loves to grind it out on the ground.
That they do. The Spot has played well, but their record doesn't really reflect that. 2-4 overall, Calico 5-1, and they picked apart Cedar Crest defense last week. So let's head to Denver and Eagle Stadium. Battle of the superb quarterbacks. Calico up 7 early, but here's Roth rolling left, spies Jacob Arndt wide open down the sideline. Burst of speed here. Can't catch him. Extra point is no good. It is 7-6.
Eagles strike right back. Pitch to Owen Zimmerman, and he is out for a nice Friday night jog untouched. Great blocking. 60 yards makes it 14-6. Eagles.
Okay, and then check out this wacky play. Roth going to be deep in his own territory, and it's picked off by Brad Heck, but then fumbled into the end zone, recovered by Ethan Steffi. So it's called a touchdown. Yeah, that just happened. Take another look. Regardless, it is more points for the Eagles, up 28-6.
All right, late in the second quarter, Garden Spot still got some fight. Roth finds Connor Finke, late TD, and then the Spot scores two quick touchdowns in the third because they got two onside kick recoveries.
Wild.
That's Javi Westmoreland catching a TD from Roth, brings him within 7.
But the grind of Calico's offense eventually wears down the Spot. Owen Zimmerman again, knifing from the defense. He and Brandon Brubaker had a field day. The Brewdozer had 3 touchdowns. You saw Owen's 2. Lots of offense, but it's Calico winning 56-28. Eagles will face Landseer Strasburg next week. E-Town, we'll see what they did against E-Town later in the show.
Key stat, Calico defense held Garden Spot scoreless in the first and the fourth quarters.
So what you got to do?
Yeah, you need to score there. All right, moving to Section 1, huge clash between Warwick, Manheim, Township, and Township leads Section 1 in rushing, while Warwick leads the section in total yards per game, averaging just over 427 per contest. Whew, that's a mouthful.
Yeah, I said the theme was offense. A lot of people calling this one a trap game for Manheim Township. Yeah. Streaks may be looking ahead to Wilson next week. Could Warwick have a big upset tonight? Well,
they did last year.
Let's find out. Warriors' victory just might be their only hope of making the 6A district playoffs. Township's offense just so solid. QB Luke MG in the rain here. Guns it near side to Brett Benjamin. Hits him in stride, and he falls into the end zone. It's a touchdown. Make it 14-0. Blue streak.
Yeah, but here we go. Ensuing kickoff. Alex Lawrence reverse handoff to Nick Fucci.
Hello.
Lawrence ran it back last week, so here's Fucci's turn. Finds the seam, slipping all over the place. Could it go all the way? Oh, not quite. Brought down at the 1, but oh no. A flag on the play, holding. It's coming all the way back. Yeah.
Well, that was a heartbreaker, but Adam Ricketts does go right to work on offense. Check out this catch from Carter Forney. Takes it away from the Tennessee defender, plus the yards after. He is an absolute workhorse.
Yeah, but this night, Township's offense, way too strong. Jordan Cruz almost gets empty for the sack, but he hangs in, throws the TD to Xavier Roman. Another score on the board. Blue Streaks are leading Lidditz with a 45-7 win. It's payback for last year, and next up, their sights are set on those Wilson Bulldogs in Week 8.
No Hail Mary in this one. Lots more to come here on High School Game Night. We'll check in on the unbeaten Mannheim Central Barons. Could they stay perfect? Find out next. We'll be right back. High School Game Night brought to you by JD's Pazzo Pizza in Ephrata. Welcome back to High School Game Night. Let's talk some Conestoga Valley. This is my favorite stat from them.
Hit me with it.
A true Jared Novak team, last in the league in rushing, but first in the league in passing.
Yeah, that actually kind of makes me chuckle a little bit when I think about it. Tanner Swilk has stepped in, done a fantastic job at quarterback. If the season ended today, by the way, Brian, Buckskins would be into the District 5A playoffs.
There you go, but they have to keep rolling. Rain's coming down hard in Whitmer, hosting Penn Manor early on. CVQB, there is Schwelt looking for Jose Barbone on the slant, but it's tipped and picked by Jacob Hollinger. Nice return here as well. Sets up the Comets in CV territory and allows their grinder of a running back, Ben Wright, to take over. Dives in for six to open up the scoring, and a little later, he is in again from in close. Both extra points, no good. It's 12-0 Comets. They're looking for more in the second quarter. Hand off to Josiah Edwards, but it's slippery out there.
Fumble.
Yosef Ben-Kazmi lowers the boom. CB recovers the fumble, and they are in business. Schwilk goes back to work, looking, finds Barbone over the middle. Would lead to a Buckskin field goal, but in the end, it's Penn Manor coming away with the victory. Final score 33-17.
All right, last game of the evening. Mannheim Central putting their unbeaten record on the line on the road at Ephrata.
Yeah, Barons look really good. Oh, yeah. Mounts battling through their final Section 2 contest here of the season. They will not play these teams again for a couple of years through the next cycle. They will be in Section 3 next year.
And that's good news. Much needed move for the Mounts. Homecoming at War Memorial Field tonight for the evening festivities. Opening kickoff, Mannheim Central takes it on the bounce. Ben Wagner setting up his blockers, busts through the effort of defense, and turns on the Jets. Gets down there in a hurry. Only 13 seconds go off the clock. Barons are up 7-0.
Nice.
Next offensive possession for them, QB Evan Simon keeps it himself, finds some room behind the blockers, scoots down the left side of the field. He's into the end zone, 14-0 Central. Can't forget about Mannheim's stud running back, Tyler Flick. There he is, untouched into the end zone for one of his TDs in the first quarter. Barons all up big at that point. Ephrata does put together a little bit of a drive later in the first. Pass complete here to Bryce Holbrider for a first down. They go over midfield. But on the next play, Caden Kiefer looking to pass, overthrows his receiver. Will Rivers picks it off and takes it the other way for another touchdown. Central never tested in this one. They win it huge, 79-7. Barons 7-0 to start the season.
They are firing all cylinders, but that's it for our highlights. Do not go anywhere. We still got to give you every score from every football game in the LL tonight. All coming your way after the break. We'll be right back.
High School Game Night is brought to you by Yogurt Works Cafe in Ephrata, where you can build it your way.
Welcome back to the postgame show. Let's go around the LL League, check out every score from the rest of the games here in Week 7. We'll start off with Brian's alma mater, J.P. McCaskey, playing well as of late, but the Black Knights do get the win there, 52-26.
Bring back Perry Patterson.
Oh, yeah, you're living in the past there, brother. Of course, Wilson racks up another victory, 68 in a row in Section 1. They beat Lebanon 46-11.
I might still have some eligibility, too. Here's a good game, Section 2, Solanco at Cedar Crest. The Falcons get the win 42-21, and more title contenders.
Yeah.
Elizabethtown versus Lampeter Strasburg. What do you know? It goes into OT. E-Town wins it 44-30.
Yeah, that's a good win for them. How about down in Section 3, Northern Lebanon out in front in the standings. They move to 3-0 in league play. beat Anvil Cleona 41-13. And in the Elko Columbia game, it's the Raiders winning it 22-16.
Non-league game for Donegal tonight. They travel up to Hazleton and knock off the 6A team 20-14.
Good win.
Where while Lancaster Catholic keeps asserting their dominance in Section 3, Crusaders move to 3-0 in league play, beating Peckway tonight 38-14.
They did start the season 0-4, so that's a good job turning it around. Got some selections here. Actually, our next game is going to be a Section 2 slobber knocker next week on BRC 11, Cedar Crest at Mannheim Central. Barons have been rolling through their Section 2 schedule. Does that continue against the Falcons? Catch it live, 7 o'clock, BRC 11. Eric May, Phil Kaufman have all the action exclusively on BRC 11.
All right, now we've also got to announce our Play of the Week nominees. Chad's excited about these. First up, Mannheim Central's Ben Wagner. The opening kickoff going to be a return for a touchdown. We had Alex Lawrence win the voting last week with a similar return. Could be
we'll
a good
see.
Open.
Yeah, I was there for that one. Maybe you like this one. Warwick Warriors, Carter Forney, a stud receiver for them, makes highlight reel catches all the time. And get some yards after the catch there.
Yeah, love a stiff arm. Here's your third option. Cocalico's Owen Zimmerman had two very long runs for touchdowns tonight. Here's the first, a 60-yard scamper in the first quarter.
Can I call that a jog? check out all the nominees again. Vote for your favorite. Head over to our blog, newslevesports.tv. We'll announce those winners next Friday on our 5 p.m. newscast. Brian, week 7 in the books. Feels really good to be back on the job here. Give us your final thoughts.
We're glad you're back. Yeah. Cocalico and Mannheim Central keep rolling in
they
Section 2.
Yeah.
But in Section 1, Mannheim Township Wilson next week. If anybody is ever going to end this Wilson winning streak in Section 1, it's probably going to be Township next week. I mean,
it's at home.
It's at home.
Yep. Seniors at quarterback and at some of the skill positions.
Right. So it's gonna be next week.
Last loss for Wilson, by the way, in Section 1 was to Mannheim Township 2007. So we'll see. We wish we could go to that, but we just can't make it out for that. That'll do it for our post-game show here on BRC 11. Thanks to our crew in the back. And until next time, I'm Chad Landers.
And I'm Brian Kast. We'll see you next Friday.
Here to go, 70 yards to the end zone.